Hey guys, Rachel Christensen here on the GH Cook campus for Ag Field Day, an annual event that takes place on campus. As you can see behind me, it's the fountain spurting out at Passion Puddle with activities going on all around. Let's take a look and see what people had in store for them on what turned out to be a great day. Amongst the many exhibits and displays offered during Ag Field Day, our own RUTV and Weather Watcher colleagues took some time out of their busy schedules to speak with us. So Brian, you're the lead producer of Weather Watcher. How was it having the table out there in front of Waller Hall?
It was a lot of fun. You know, we got some decent attention, got to give away some free stuff to all the people, some pens, you know, all that good swag stuff. And we got to really get a good chance to showcase our program, and we had it running on our little computer screen there, so people got a good feel of what it was all about.
Excellent. And now you guys went live on Channel 6?
We did. We did a couple of, we'll call them, weather broadcasts / live updates right here from Ag Field Day. We kind of showcased a little bit of what's going on around here, hit some of the high points, and of course, talked about the weather as well.
I know, and it turned out to be a pretty decent day after all. Did you guys get to experience some of the activities going on around?
Not so much yet, but we'll get there.
Throughout the day, students, staff, volunteers, alumni, and community residents came together to celebrate this century-long tradition. With anything and everything going on, there was certainly plenty to do and never a dull moment. Crowds of people showed up to see a dog show, check out a variety of plants and flowers, get their faces painted, visit a petting zoo, or even just relax. The activities and weather alone were enough to make the day worthwhile.
Today's the 90th anniversary, so it's good to come out to see old friends who graduated and came back to campus. And yeah, I think I'm going to keep coming back even after I graduate, so it's a great tradition here at Rutgers.
Nice. And did you get a chance to experience any of the activities besides your own booth?
Yeah, I walked around. I went over to College Farm Road to see the petting the animal zoo, so that was fun. And then went around, grabbed some funnel cake with a few of my friends, so
nice.
It's a great time to be out on campus.
I worked all day at the SCBS Cook Council booth for Pie to President. People got to throw plates full of whipped cream at me for a dollar.
Okay.
Yeah, the dunk tank, that was actually our idea at first. And then we got contacted by the other group saying that they're already doing it. So it's like, you know, dunk tanks are fun. Kids love them. The entire campus is very open. And that you really, it doesn't matter whether you're Rutgers affiliated or if you're just stopping by. It's kind of like when I was younger, we had the state fair up by me, the Farm and Horse Show. It's just like that. Same aspect. Less commercialized. A lot more localized. I just hope it stays like this. I don't want to see it, as they move to a more Rutgers-centric setup, I don't want to see Ag Field Day forgotten and kind of pushed by the wayside.
Well, Ag Field Day isn't over just yet, so I'm going to get out there and enjoy the rest of the festivities. Maybe tie-dye a shirt, maybe get this little cheek of mine painted. For RUTV, I'm Rachel Christensen.